The divisive austerity debate is raging in Europe this Tuesday amid signals the EU may be ready to relax its deficit-cutting drive. There are influential voices on both sides of the fence. This man, the Goldman Sachs CEO, says the UK should stay the course without its spending, with its spending cuts. He told the BBC the pace of austerity should be eased, but in the end, the deficits must be reduced. Last week, IMF Managing Director Christine Lagarde said it might be time for the UK to reconsider its spending cuts. The IMF's chief economist, Olivier Blanchard, says the UK is, quote, playing with fire. Bill Gross, founder and chief investment officer at PIMCO, says the UK and most of Europe is wrong in thinking that spending cuts will produce growth. He told the Financial Times, you've got to spend money, and warned that bond traders didn't want to see severe belt tightening without growth. Well, on Monday, European Commission President Jose Manuel Barroso called for states to focus less on cutting spending and more on stimulating growth. He told a think tank in Brussels that whilst the policy of austerity is fundamentally right, he thinks it has reached its limits. Germany still backs balanced budgets. Today, its finance ministry said that Germany's austerity measures are rebuilding the trust of international investors lost in the crisis. Well, Olli Rehn is vice president of the European Commission. He told me that as Europe's growth forecasts weaken, policymakers are adapting to the changing circumstances.
We have, constantly adjusted our policies in order to facilitate and enable sustainable growth and growth-friendly fiscal consolidation. To give you an example, the fiscal consolidation is moving with a slower pace in Europe this year, 2013, than in 2012. In other words, last year the fiscal effort was in structural terms 1.5% of GDP, while this year it is in the scale of 3/4 of percent. In the US, in the meantime, the fiscal effort is between 1.5% and 2%, so clearly larger than in the European Union.
The feeling is, though, that you're losing the argument because whatever is being done, it feels like there's a lot of pain in Europe right now. It's not producing growth, and there isn't any sort of sense that it will, actually. There's no hard figures to give a sense that it will increase growth.
I'm fully aware of the problems related to high levels of unemployment and low growth in many European countries. That's why it is essential that we work in order to support sustainable growth and job creation through reforms, through targeted investment, and by having a sensible approach on fiscal consolidation. But at the same time, we also have to realize that the debt levels in Europe are about 90%, around 90% this year, and it is having a drag on growth. So we have a very difficult balance. On the one hand, support sustainable growth and job creation, while at the same time having a consistent consolidation of our public finances.